to deal with Hamas, Hezbollah, to deal with Lebanon, to deal with Iraq and Iran. And right now, Iran loves what's happening. We're playing right into their
hands.
Will you
vote to cut off funding for the war?
I will vote to change the funding to a different mission. I will fund the troops to protect the national security interests of America, to accomplish a mission that increases our national security and protects the troops themselves.
Senator, if a majority of the Congress wants a different policy, if a majority of the American people want a different policy, can you sustain a war without their support?
Not forever. The majority of Americans were opposed to and wanted us out of Korea. Thanks to a very brave president named Harry Truman, Korea is now, at least South Korea, is now free today. On this issue of bringing up the men and women who are serving and how they feel about the war, look, I hear from them all the time. I lament the loss of those brave two young Americans who wrote that piece. I hear from hundreds of them every day. Just like in Vietnam, despite what was accepted, Americans wanted to win in Vietnam, they want to win here. I hear from these men and women, hundreds of them, all the time. They want us to win. And to go back to the same failed strategy of before and somehow say that everything's going to be fine in the Middle East if we announce that we're leaving, I think does not comport with reality or history. And we've been through these fights before as to whether the United States should direct its influence throughout the world. And I believe that this is some way a repeat of that. But the fact is that we are succeeding militarily. We are succeeding in a new tactic, and that is succeeding. And in Anbar province, by the way, I asked General Petraeus. He said the reason why we had the success in Anbar province is we had the extra 4,000 Marines to send there. And that was solidified that position. We all want to see progress. We are seeing progress. To pull the plug at this particular time, I believe, would be disastrous for the future of this country.
When you say win, how do you define win?
The same way you succeed in any counterinsurgency. The government functions effectively. There's an environment of security. There's probably long-term conflicts within the country, as there has been with other insurgency. But basically, you continue to progress and bring a free and open and democratic society and fight back. Look, this is an evil influence. They think they're winning. Maybe John doesn't. But if you listen to bin Laden, Zarqawi, and all that, they say they drove us out of Beirut, they drove us out of Mogadishu, they hit the USS Cole, they attacked our embassies, and they're saying, we'll drive them out of Iraq, and we will succeed.
And where is he saying
that listen to what he said?
He's saying that from the border of Afghanistan and Pakistan.
And he's able to reach every corner of the world.
Yeah, and he's able to do it because this administration took their eye off of him and chose to go to war in a place that had nothing to do with the war on terror. And the fact is, as I said before, Al-Qaeda loves our being in Iraq. If you want to put Al-Qaeda off balance,
Al-Qaeda
then change the equation. And Iran loves the fact that we're in Iraq.
And Iran is getting stronger.
Excuse me?
And Iran loves to be in Iraq, and they are.
Well, Iran is in Iraq.
And Al-Qaeda is in Iraq. And Al-Qaeda is, if we don't continue to beat them back, will be a major influence and have training bases.
Yes, you are, because we've said we're going to continue to fight.
You are asking to go back to a failed strategy that had failed for nearly 4 years that many of us pointed out that you voted for.